The nodes are the corners and the edges are, if two nodes are joined by a straight line, we will, you know, in this solid, then we will say it is an edge. So a graph is just, you give a set of nodes and you give a set of edges. There are graphs that occur in real life. For example, you can look at the railway map of India. The nodes are the stations, the edges. You can look at the bus routes of Chennai. So the nodes are the bus stops, and the edges are non-stop services between two things. So things like that. So we will just simplify this whole study by trying to look at these graphs. And what I'll try to give you are some very simple constructions of these graphs, which are associated to platonic solids. So firstly, this you can recognize, right? It's nothing but this. But I've drawn it only as a graph. So it has four corners, 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you think of it as, this corner here is joined to this corner, it's joined to this corner, there's a straight edge going from here to all the remaining three corners. So this graph is a graph where everything is connected to everything. It's called a complete graph. It's called K4. Complete in German is spelled with K, I guess. And so K4, complete graph with four vertices. So this is the tetrahedron thought of as a graph. And from this, you can see it's very symmetric. Of course, the way I've drawn it, it's not so symmetric. But when you look at this, you realize every vertex is connected to exactly three other vertices. And you can take these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and rearrange them in any other order and you will still have the same shape. Okay, so this is very easy, the tetrahedron as a graph. Just take all four vertices and join every pair of them. So what about the cube? So the cube has eight vertices, right? So let's just see how to draw this. 8, 4 in front, 4 at the back, 8 vertices. So so let's see how we can draw them as a graph. So here's one. This symmetry group, I don't know, how many of you know group theory? It's probably,
Most of them
know group theory. Oh, then you know what this I mean by this. So the symmetry group is S4. It's all permutations of the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm just saying, you look at the edges, the vertices, think of that as they're numbered 1, 2, 3, 4. And what are all the ways I can rearrange them and still preserve these edge relations? That means after permuting, if two things are connected by an edge, after permuting also they should be connected by an edge. But since everything is connected by an edge, there's nothing here. This is a easy example. I'm spending more time on it just so that we can understand the basics. Okay, let's go to the slightly more difficult thing, the cube. Okay, so this cube, let us try to understand its symmetries. So by symmetry, I just mean some physical transformation, some rotation about some axis. So physical transformation is you have some axis, you can move it around. Let's not allow that. Let's keep the center at the same place. And after that, what you can do, you can fix any axis through the center and you can rotate it by any angle you like. Okay, that's what I mean by a physical motion. Is that clear? So that's any rigid object, you move it, you are translating it, and then you are taking some axis and rotating it about that. That's it. There's nothing else you can do in real life with rigid objects. And now this, let's try to understand what are the physical motions which if I do, the shape will not change. Okay, so there's some obvious ones. It has a lot of symmetry. I can take this and I can rotate it by maybe 45 degrees, by 90 degrees, by 180 degrees and 270 degrees along this axis. I can do the same thing along this axis. I can do the same along this axis. More interestingly, let me ask, suppose I keep it like this and we focus on this point here. Now I ask, what are the physical motions I can do that fix this point? I don't want to move this point.
car में diagonally आपको car है can rotate.
I can rotate
yes.
like this. So I'll take the axis which passes through this,
yes.
and there is one more corner on the other side. I can rotate.
Yes.
Okay. So how much should I rotate? 360. Okay, I come back. Can I? So that is. It's the same as doing nothing. Can I do something else? I can rotate by 120 degrees. See, there are three these things. I can rotate it by 120 degrees like this. And then again by another 120 degrees. So I can rotate it by 120 or 240 degrees. So while fixing this, I can rotate by 120 and 240. So there are, or I can do nothing. So there are three symmetries which fix this. And then there are other symmetries which can take this point to any other point. For example, I can use my rotation to take this point to this point, and then another rotation by 90 degrees. I can take any point to any other point. So there are three symmetries which fix each point, and there are eight points. Using these two facts and a little bit of group theory, you can show that there are 8 into 3, totally 24 symmetries of the cube. Totally 24 symmetries of the cube. Okay, so by which, what another way of thinking about this, if you know some group theory, if you don't worry about it. You think of the 8 corners as 8 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And you ask, in what way can I permute these 8 points so that they remain the corners of a cube? Okay, and there are 24 such ways. I wanted to write something. I'll show you with a simpler example of what I mean. So I'll just 1, 2, 3, 4. I somehow number it. The numbers are not important. You could do 1, 2, 3, 4 or whatever. And now I'm asking, what are the symmetries of the square? Okay, so one way of thinking about it is geometrically using rotations, and then you have to talk about cos theta, sine theta. But a much simpler way is to just talk about permutations. So I have these points 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, if I take rotation by 90 degrees, then what happens? This 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 4, and 4 goes to 1. So I can write it like this, 2, 3, 4, 1. 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 4, 4 goes to 3. This is a permutation. Okay, I have rearranged the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 in a different order. And so now I ask, how many different permutations are there which will preserve this this structure of the square? That means that I am asking how many, so there are 4 points. So I'm asking how many permutations are there. So what is a permutation? It's a function sigma from the set 1, 2, 3, 4 to the set 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 1 to 1 and on to. It's a bijection. That it will also have an inverse. So I'm asking how many of these are there? Which will, if I and J are connected by an edge, then sigma I and sigma j are also connected by an edge. Okay, so let's try to solve this problem here. So now firstly what you do is you ask, so we can just write it down. In this case, there's rotation by 90 degrees, rotation, so then what will happen? 1, 2, 3, 4 will go to 2, 3, 4, 1. 1 and 2 are connected by an edge. 2 and 3 are also connected by an edge. 2 and 3 are connected by an edge. 3 and 4 are connected by an edge. 3 and 4 are connected by an edge. 4 and 1 are connected by an edge. 4 and 1 are connected by an edge. 2 and 3, 4 goes to 1 and 1 goes to 2. So 1 and 2 are also connected by an edge. So that edge relation is preserved by this permutation. And there are these 4 and anything more? That is, first is this 1, 2, 3, 4. Goes to 1, 2, 3, 4. Second is rotation by 90 degrees. So I'm only writing the second row. I'm not writing the first row. 2, 3, 4, 1. Can someone tell me something more? 3, 4, 1, 2. So 1 goes to 3, 2 goes to, so that's a 180 degree rotation. And one more. So you can also take the counterclockwise or rotation by 270 degrees. So that is 1 goes to 4, 4 goes, 2 goes to 1, 3 goes to 2, and 4, 1, 2, 3. And there's another interesting one, which is 1 goes to 3 and 2 goes to 4. One goes to 3, 2 goes to 4, 3 goes to 1, and 4 goes to 2. This one. But this one is a bit strange because it is a reflection. It is not a rotation. If you were a two-dimensional animal living in a two-dimensional space, you would not be able to do this. It would be like taking my right hand and doing something to it and making it look like my left hand. You would not be able to do it. You cannot do it. You take your right hand, cut it off, do whatever you like with it. It will never look like your left hand. Unless you go into four-dimensional space and do something, then you can do it. Like here also, this, suppose I drew my hand here, for example, and you all know that this is probably, this is my right hand. And without coming out of the plane, you can never turn it into my left hand. But if you pull it out and rotate it, you can turn it. So this one is not physical. It's called orientation reserving, reversing. So what I'm trying to say is for this cube now, there are actually 24 symmetries. So now we have 8 vertices, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Potentially there are 8 factorial permutations of 8 objects. 8 factorial is huge, no? It's, yeah.
40,000.
Okay, 40,000. 320. So it's huge. But the cube has only these 24 symmetries. Do you know some group which is of size 24, if you know group theory? 24 is?
Just mention.
Can you factorize 24? 24 is 2 into 3 into 4. So it's 4 factorial, right? So 24 means there are, it's the same as the group of, not the same, the size is the same as permutations on four letters. Okay, so is there a way to construct a cube graph as using something which shows that this symmetry of four letters in it? That's the question.